Hi, I'm Tiffany Cross with the Beat DC, and I've teamed up with theGrio to bring you all you need to know from Capitol Hill. This new Congress is the most diverse in history, and people of color are shaping policies that will directly impact your life. So here's a brief look at what you need to know right now. Let's get started. More than 10,000 people are released from America's state and federal prisons every week, and many find the transition back into society challenging and are not prepared for life on the outside. As a result, two-thirds of former prisoners are arrested again within 3 years of release. Senator Cory and Congressman Elijah Cummings introduced this week the New Pathways Act to set these returning citizens up for success. The bill will ensure they get help with things like a driver's license or a birth certificate, social security cards, a photo ID, or work forms. These documents are priceless to getting housing, jobs, and social services, and making sure these returning citizens become contributing members to the community instead of being locked up again. As you know, criminal justice has been a pertinent issue in this Congress. Georgetown University students vote today to create a fund for descendants of slaves that were once sold by the school. If approved, tuition would increase by $27.20 each semester, and those funds would be given to the estimated 4,000 descendants of the 272 slaves sold by Georgetown in 1838 to raise money for the school. This would be the first slavery reparations policy at any major university in the U.S., a timely move as the issue has become more than just a talking point among Democrats in the 2020 campaign. Now I want to talk to you about the Justice Department. According to reports, most major categories of hate crimes, whether motivated by race, religion, or sexual orientation, have increased under the Trump administration. But the president's hand-picked Attorney General, Bill Barr, said in a congressional hearing this week that he was unaware of this data. Now, the proverbial side eye is definitely warranted here, but let's just dig deeper for a moment. Barr is the country's top law enforcement official. So how is it this guy is completely unaware or indifferent to the rise of hate crimes in this country? And here's the irony. The same day he made these statements, another congressional hearing was happening just a few feet away to address the rise of white nationalism. Barr's own Justice Department reported in November that hate crimes spiked 17% in 2017. And just today, the son of a Louisiana sheriff's deputy is in custody in connection to the recent burning of three black churches. So does the Attorney General just not read, or does he choose to be woefully ignorant? I can't get into all the damage that Donald Trump's Justice Department has caused. We'd be here all day. But here's just a few. Hate crime prosecutions have fallen roughly a fifth under Trump. The DOJ has targeted voting rights, affirmative action, killed community policing reforms, ended school safety plans, targeted Obamacare, and have reversed numerous Obama-era positions on many more civil rights policies. Trump's DOJ has redefined whose civil rights they want to protect, focusing instead on Christian conservatives, police officers, and local officials who maintain they've been trampled by the federal government. So when the Attorney General of the United States feigns ignorance about what's happening in this country, let me remind you, Bill Barr had to be confirmed by a Republican Senate whom you elect. The next time an election happens, remember that this Attorney General is the consequence of not voting. Participate in every election and raise the bar. But those are my thoughts, and I want to know yours. So tweet me at Tiffany D. Cross and let me know. And that's what's up for DC360, and we will see you next time.